Hello everyone, and welcome again to another live here in my Instagram thread. Today I have a very special guest. She is actually a very, very close friend and like a sister to me, actually. So I want to introduce you to her. Some of you know her. It's Michelle Horowitz from the Wholesome Fertility. And she's going to be talking today about mind hacks to invite peace on the fertility journey. And I think she's already connected. Let me try to see. Yes, I am going to add her in it right now. Let's see. I put the volume here.
Hi. Let me lower this. I'm very low here. Hold on.
Me too. So hold on. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Okay, so yes, I was telling the audience that I have a very special guest, so it's actually you. Most of them they already know us, you know, so like they know who you are, who I am. Oh, I was telling them that you're gonna talk today, because you are my guest, about mind hacks to invite peace on our fertility journey, which is really kind of, you know, very necessary, because this is so stressful. You know, I left the talk to you, Michelle. First, you know, we always get new followers. So maybe do a little introduction about who you are and then take it from there on really the title says everything, you know. So we go free flow like always. So here you are.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for having me, Monica. And thank you guys for being here. My name is Michelle Horowitz. And I'm a fertility acupuncturist, or I'm an acupuncturist Chinese medicine physician who specializes in fertility. I also learned hypnosis, hypnotherapy. I have a background in Ayurveda. I love working on the whole person, and I'm really, really into the mind. The mind is so intriguing to me. And today I'm going to be talking about a couple of hacks that you can do when you're going through the fertility journey. Okay, so I'll start with one thing. Just a little fun fact, or something that I think a lot of people might realize, is that most of the time when we're trying to address the mind, we try to access it through the mind. But when we're in a state that's not ideal, then it's actually going to make us, it's going to make us spin our wheels and spin around in circles. So some of the ways actually to impact the mind is using our bodies. So today I'm going to start with the breath. Breathing is a really important and easy trick to impact the mind. Why? Because it's your breath. Number one, it's both voluntary and involuntary. So obviously, yes, you're gonna breathe all the time. It's just something that you do, you know, obviously. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here listening. And one of the things that happens is that our breath actually tells us a lot about our mental state. So if you sit down and just pay attention to your breath at any given moment, you'll start to realize that your breath actually reflects your mental state. So if you're anxious, you breathe typically more shallow, tense, and fast. And when you're sitting by the beach and you have not a care in the world, you actually feel more freedom in your breath. Your breath is more deep, it's more slow, and it's longer. So that's something that you'll start to realize. Now, the trick is if you do that, if you create the type of breath that you have with the desired feeling that it gives, then you'll be able to access or calm your mind through the breath. Not by thinking about it, but through the breath. Yeah. So there's a couple of things. Today I'm going to talk about the 4-7-8 breath. It's basically a proportionate breath. So what it is that you inhale for four, to the count of four, and then you hold your breath for seven counts, and then you exhale with a swoosh out of your mouth, eight counts, and you keep repeating this. And I think actually even the counting, when you're counting and breathing, it kind of shifts you away from your emotions at that moment. So that immediately will have an impact on your mental, like, well-being at that moment. So that's a really strong one.
So you mentioned is inhale like in four cones to inhale, then hold for seven cones, and then out from the mouth in how yes. much? Eight cones?
Eight. Okay. Yeah. So it's a four, okay. seven, eight.
Four, seven, eight.
Yeah. And so it has an immediate impact. Another thing that has an impact and actually helps cross both parts of our brains or use mm-hmm. both parts of the brain is alternate nostril breathing. And people use this like this type of thing. It's kind of like the surfer dude.
Yes.
So it's kind of actually a surfer dude's very relaxed and calm, yes. right? So you can use this and then you cover one side. Obviously, you want to blow out your nose, get everything out first.
Yes.
And then you can cover one side and then inhale from one side. And then hold it for a couple of seconds. And it's up to you how long this, because it's kind of like, and then exhale from the right side.
Yes.
And then inhale again.
And the opposite.
And hold it and then exhale. And then you keep doing that. And so what it does is that actually because of the nose, in the olfactory nerve, it can impact immediately your psyche.
It is so true. You know that I had one time.
Aromatherapy, that's why it works so easily.
Yes, and you know, it's well known that also helps to lower the heart rate. Like for example, when someone is stressed,
yeah.
our heart rate goes fast.
Yes.
Or a person that has like anxiety attacks, that the heart rate goes so fast that this, you know, from the same attack, they can think that they're going to die because it's very scary.
Yes.
This is an incredible exercise. I had years ago something yeah. like that. I was super stressed. I was in my period. So all the things were like kind of together. And mm-hmm. I had kind of like, not an anxiety attack, but you know, I was so overwhelmed. You know, that sometimes our brain cannot take it, you know, it's so much. And you know, I had my husband, I think, talked with someone like a yoga teacher. And through, you know, she called me through the phone. She teached me that because I felt that my heart was going like a million per second. I was so scared from that, you know, because you feel
yeah, it. Feels like that. It feels like you have a heart attack.
Yes, yes. So yeah, she did that for like about 20 minutes. It's incredible, Michelle, you say it. And also you mentioned something in the, like in one of our conversations before, that we breathe through the, you know, like through here, through the chest, and the correct breathe is to the stomach. So, you know, I don't want to forget about that.
So we'll talk about breathing. So we talk about how breathing is involuntary and voluntary all at the same time.
Yes.
And so, of course, you're going to breathe because you need to breathe. But you, that does not necessarily mean that you're breathing the full potential of your lungs.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the ways, most of the time we breathe through the chest, it's just a habit. We try to hold in our stomach and look good, you know. So we breathe through the chest.
Yes, it's true.
Chest is not the most, if you're just breathing from the chest, you're just using really a very small part of your breathing ability. Plus, it's not the best place to get oxygen. The best place really is your diaphragm. And so the diaphragm is like right below, it's kind of like right above your belly button. And so if you look at babies, they breathe from their stomach.
Yes.
Why look at babies? Because that's how naturally we're supposed to be. It's the nature. They breathe through their stomach. They don't breathe through their chest. That's the natural way to breathe. We, over time, learn a wrong way to breathe. So it's the stomach, you're also... you're almost like massaging and using your diaphragm, and that immediately has a very calming effect on your psyche as well.
Yeah, I started to practice that since we talked last time, and it's true because even when, for example, when I see my daughter, Maya, sleeping, and I want to know that she's breathing because I have that from, you know, like,
yeah,
and it's her stomach. So, you know, I don't know, I think it has to do with all the stress and all the things that happen day by day as we, you know, get an adult or whatever, or we go past certain age, that we just, you know, kind of forget what helped us to be a little bit less stressed, right?
Yes. And it also, sometimes people say that if you want to stop feeling, you stop breathing. People will stop breathing if they're feeling a very, very difficult emotion.
Yeah.
So natural tendency to do that. However, by breathing through it, you're actually getting the energy to flow through your body better. And it's more important to do that because that's how blocks start to occur, is when we stop and we hold it in into place. So it's actually better to breathe through it. And thing you said about your heart going really fast, your breath actually directly impacts your heart. Well, the reason why your heart is so that it can get your blood to flow through your body. What does the blood carry? It carries oxygen. So the heart and the lungs, you know, they actually have a strong communication. The artery pushes to the lungs and then it comes back out and pushes through the rest of the body. So when you're breathing, your breath, you know, when your heart beats really fast, you start to breathe really fast.
Yes, that's true. That's true too. That's why when you know, when I tell you that it happens to me, that thing, she told me exactly what you do. She even told me, you know, because she's yoga, like to put it, like you said, like that. And this, yes. And something in the third eye too.
You can,
And then when you get scared, when we get the heart rate is, you know, high. Your breathing is fast as the heart rate. So then you start to, with your mind start to get panic.
That's
so
right.
To make it worse. So it is really a guidance that we need to have somehow. And you know, when we go into fertility journey, it's even worse. You know, like we
can.
We don't have that panic attacks, but it's something that can bring a lot of stress.
Absolutely.
When we, for example, have a transfer, they say you are poop or not, pregnant until proving the opposite or whatever it is.
Yeah.
So that also can affect that embryo and the fact of the attaching of the embryo.
Yes. And so it does. It does. And it also, you know, it can, stress, it just affects your body in so many different levels. It messes up your hormones because it increases cortisol. Stress can stop people's periods. I mean, stress really does have an impact. Another thing that you can do while you're doing the breath, actually, you were talking about the point. There's a point right here. It's really like the third eye point. And what's interesting is, so when you do this, it actually has a very calming effect on your spirit.
Oh, wow.
And to me, it's kind of interesting. It's like a point of the third eye, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's insight. And it's like if you really do see the truth, you realize that there's nothing to fear, you know, and you're kind of getting yourself back to that ultimate reality. You know, there's this reality, the reality we choose, the reality we see through our perception, and this is the ultimate reality.
Yes, it's so true. And then, Michelle, now, breathe definitely is one of the, I will say, the main thing, you know, when we learn how to breathe. Breathing is such a powerful tool, and we don't even have idea because, like you said, you know, it just automatically become like kind of like a machine. You know, we breathe, we have the air.
Yeah.
What other things we can add to this main tool? Because I will say is the key to anything. What other tips you can give us?
So a couple of other things. Smiling.
Yes, it's true.
Yeah, smiling. When you smile, you usually don't smile when you panic or are stressed out, right?
Yeah.
So, and the body, the mind will read the body and the mind will impact the body. So if you smile, it's a little hack. You're tricking your mind into thinking that you're feeling good.
Yes.
And all is well. So you can smile and walk around or hold a pencil in your mouth, which forces a smile. And then you can even this or like the, you know, the Wonder Woman pose, you know, just changing your physiology immediately makes you feel more empowered. And anxiety and power, they kind of don't go hand in hand. Like if you put yourself into the power, then you feel strong and calm. It's like this calm alert.
So yes. Really,
of course, meditation is great, but knowing the situation, if it's so difficult, probably the last thing you want to do at that moment when you're really feeling it is meditation. So another thing that's really good is you can even put aromatherapy in the room, like a little bit of lavender, a little bit of chamomile, maybe even a tiny bit of like a lemon or something citrusy. And just have it in the diffuser in the room. So having that also creates a state of peace, you know.
Yes. Because it's a smell comes through the breathing. It's so, you know, you see how it's connected? And yes, there is a smell that can change our mood. You know, like I love the mix of citrus and sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And it even can help us, I think, to go through the day in a more like fast pace, but relaxed, you know, when we have a lot of things to do.
It has an impact, like an immediate impact on your psyche. It's really amazing.
Yes, when you say smiling, that like even fake it, there is this, you know, it's so true. Fake it until you make it. It is absolutely true. You know, some people, you know, might get triggered about that because like, oh, you are not authentic or something. But sometimes there is no other way but to force ourselves.
Yes.
Because our subconscious is so tricky. It tricks us, you know?
And if you fake it, just it's not being fake. It's a tool. Eventually, it'll be authentic because all you're doing is changing gears. It's just a quicker way to change gears. Our mind wants to go in this direction, and it's causing us suffering. So let's switch gears. How do we switch gears? Sometimes you have to fake it. I mean, you do that, you know, with a tantrum child or a dog, you know, where you're teaching them. Sometimes you have to give them a little, like, something different or trick them a little bit to switch that mental train.
Yes, you know, I actually, I was watching the other day a movie with my husband. I think it's in Apple TV, about, for example, mushrooms. You know, like we eat, this is the only source of food that had vitamin D, the ones, of course, that are eatable. Incredible movie about exactly that, how, you know, like it goes through the plants, just like nature, you know, and how they are now using it in some places because they reapproved the research on that, you know, psilocybin for treating PTSD and all of that. Why I'm talking about this? Because it's what you just said. So there was these two patients that they interview with cancer, and one of her, I think one of them years ago had some fertility issues. They didn't have that. And they are very scared. So, you know, they go to this place in the university, I don't remember what, and it's basically fake it until you make it, because what it does is kind of putting that individual in a mental state that even if they want to think about the worst negative thing and the fear of the chemotherapy and all of that, somehow is redirecting the mind to feel kind of free and relaxed, and that fear goes away. So you know, like sometimes we have to force ourselves to do that because you know there is no other way.
Listen, you know, the bottom line is it works.
Exactly. It works.
Who cares what it is, you know, and like judging it is, it's not going to help in any way. Just this, you know, it works. It's a trick, and use it just for that. Like not take it as any other way. Just use it as a trick. And another thing too is walking. We had talked about that. Taking a walk, you're changing your scenery and your environment. It automatically influences your mind. So like all these things that we're talking about have nothing to do with the mind. It's not coming from, it has to do with the mind and how it affects it, but you're doing it physically. So you're smelling something, you're breathing, you're walking, you're smiling, you're changing your physiology. These are all physical things as a way to impact your mind. So it's not like you're coming in by trying to analyze your thoughts in that state. Forget it. It's a trap if you try to go through it from here.
And it's incredible because it makes so much sense and why it seems like that we eventually need to force it. So going back to the fake it until you make it. Because emotions, and I've been there, emotions are stronger than the physical things. Emotions can put a person in such a dark place that you just want to find a solution to physically disappear. So when you know that when your physique is disconnected with emotion, you don't feel anything. And I tell you, for example, when I went through the stillbirth of my baby, it was like that. So that's why, for example, a lot of people, and especially teenage, and I am very open to talk about that now, Michelle, because you know we have that. A lot of teenage and parents suffer from, you know, with their teenager kids or even young people from self-harm because it's the opposite. They are so emotionally drained and in a very dark state, depression, anxiety, you know. Now with all this situation with the lockdown and everything, mental health has been so much more growing that what they do to run away from this emotional thing that is hurting them so much, they distract that with self-harm. So when we do switch that it's more difficult to kind of switch it to the other way, you know, like try to train that emotion to be that part that control the physical and, you know, be more calm. You know, it makes sense to you what I'm saying?
Because you're basically doing physically as a reflection of your mind.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with the breath. The breath becomes a reflection of our mind. So we can change our breath to impact our mind, and we can use our physiology to impact our mind.
Yes.
But you're seeing what happens when you get stressed and you're constricting your breath. So you breathe more shallow, and it impacts and hurts the breath. The same thing with being in a really, really dark place, you're hurting your body. So you're getting this reflection. So if you utilize the physicality in a positive way, you can impact your mind.
Definitely. Yes. So it's, you know, it's like I wanted to touch that point because somehow when someone, you know, like you see a lot of you did it yourself, you know, mm-hmm. when with your thing, with your periods, remember you told me
mm-hmm.
there was something that it was outside, you know, like from your body and,
mm-hmm.
And you did it, you know, like you went to this holistic thing and worked
yes.
it out and you regulated yes. in the natural way. So
very.
It's incredible.
Yeah. So
you know,
yeah.
Michelle, it's awesome. It's amazing all the things because we never are aware on how a little thing that is so small but is in the same time so big, like breathing
yeah.
and how you say that, awakening our senses, you know, through the eyes too. You know,
yes.
like I can't see blood, for example. Zero.
Yes.
I feel it's so strong
yeah.
that I feel like
sure.
it's
yeah.
yeah, in my physical. Yeah, no, I can't say. If I would be a doctor, all my patients would have died.
my husband can handle it. It's like, because, you know, that's what he does. All, but my kids are like, oh, okay.
Yeah, so through the eyes, you know, the eyes. So when you say walk, a walk, if we walk in a place that there is like trees and nature
yeah.
and, you know, birds, it's like you are stimulating all these senses.
Mm-hmm.
And by default, that calm, you know, environment
right.
calm ourselves. The same if we
yes.
are, you know, like living in a city and it's tons of noise, you also get, you know, affected by that environment.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And we're so much part of nature. What's amazing is that when we go into nature, first of all, we entrain. Entrain something is we basically mimic nature. So nature is already balanced. Obviously, it gets affected over time, you know, that kind of thing. But when you're walking outside and you see life force energy in the trees and the plants, you feel the breeze, you hear the birds, you see the sky, you see the sun, all
yes.
of those things have an impact on our minds, on our physiology. It has a very calming impact on us. And many people talk about how healing it is. And it's usually people who have given it a chance to spend enough time in nature. Because I can tell you almost 100% anybody who does is going to feel that impact.
Yes.
Because we are part of nature. We forget that, but we are part of nature. So getting that sunlight, getting that energy also impacts our psyche and how we feel.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, Michelle, I really appreciate that you always come with these things that even now I need it. You know, I have like trillions of things to do today. You know, so then I'm like, okay, we need to deal with this, you know, like breathe. And I think that for our audience, especially, you know, going through this fertility journey that is stress in any way, even when you try to conceive naturally, it's a little
yeah.
bit stress, but much more when we go through, you know, all these treatments and we need to run every day for a blood test. It's like it's a stressful journey from A to Z, even until we have the baby.
It is absolutely, yeah.
You know, so all these tricks really are tricks, but eventually, like you mentioned, they become a habit and they become an authentic part of our, you know, of our actions if we use them correctly. Breathing, the key, and then from breathing, everything else comes to the senses. Michelle, thank you so much, my darling. I hope to have you again.
Yes, thank you, Monica, for having me.
No. Always is a pleasure. I was telling my audience that you are like a sister to me.
I feel the same way. Ditto.
Yes. We got like the best connection ever. So for everyone, I'm going to have the video today. If I turn it, like I usually take it down after having it for the day, and I edit it very nicely, put something for the replay, I will send it to you if you want to share it in your Instagram too, Michelle.
Awesome. Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So everyone, thank you. If you have questions, you just post it in the comments, tag me or Michelle, and I will be coordinating another live with her. Everyone have a beautiful day. Love and light to everyone.
Mwah.
Mwah. Bye.